somebody dies, somebody in trouble. You just can't know when these things are going to happen. I remember yesterday Brother Billy had something else to go and do on anniversary, and I told Brother Billy, I said, but the woman didn't tell me she was going to die. The woman did not tell me she was going to die. So I cannot tell you, again, I cannot tell you before that we have a funeral. The people come and tell me only before if we could do the funeral. And you know what has been the hardest thing? And I would say real open and real plain. What has been the hardest thing is that they are going to a big church. The same lady there, I've been asking her to come to church all the time. She might play the keyboard. Who played the keyboard this morning? All right, hey man, you could go down. You could go down. Corella, could you play the keyboard, please? Anybody not play the keyboard, only go and sit, please. Praise the Lord, everybody. Yeah. What I'm saying this morning is that things will happen. People can't tell you they're going to die. How do you tell you they're going to die? They cannot tell you that. But when it do happen, we cannot just push it away, we have to go and do something about it. Amen. So, yesterday, first thing I asked him, I said, well, where your pastor? Where your pastor? You know, you went to that big church, where the pastor? They said, well, you know, this pastor is be busy. How could I say I am too busy when someone is in trouble? And especially when that takes place, you have to make sure that you are here, everybody. You have to make sure, you know, we come together quick and see whatever we can do. God is a good God. Amen. Sometimes you might have to inconvenience yourself. You might have to put out what you have to do in order to go and attend to these kind of things like death and all these things, because serious things will come up and you cannot tell me, well, you know, I didn't prepare, well, I had something else to do. The things that you had to do, I want to believe that if the things you had to do is so much more important than to go and do, yeah, what I mean, help out somebody in the time of death and the time of trouble. I don't, what we have to do is so much more important than this kind of problem. Amen? So, this is what God called us to do. He said, if we love Him, feed His sheep, and that is what we are about to do, and that's what we will always do. So I want to say, we must have a certain amount of brilliancy. We must have a certain amount of, we know, you know, the Bible says, our spirit must be quickened. We must learn to act one time, act fast. If you're in a house and you catch a fire, what will you do? What will you do? Take a magazine and learn about how to escape fire and start to read? You run for your life. Amen, everybody? Somebody say hallelujah. Come on, it's Sunday morning. Sunday morning, everybody. Time to wake up. Woo! Hey! Yeah! Wake up from your stand. Hey! Hey, it's about time. Hey! Shut up, boy. Now it's up. Oh, do, we must be able to touch Him. We must be able to touch Him. You see how we worship Him? We must be able to touch. Our worship must be able to touch Him. And the only how our worship will touch God is if it comes straight from your spirit, straight with a pure heart to God's spirit. Whatever we ask for, in our prayer, we must be able to touch Him. You know something? Prophetess, where is Prophetess? Could you come to the front, please? Let me tell you something. I was praying last night, and this is truth, nothing but the truth. And I did not call up the people. I did not call. Who I call on the phone? Anybody? No, I didn't call. And I was praying last night, but because my prayer was touching God, God was speaking. I know God is speaking to me. God was speaking to me and was telling me. Now, the first thing I tell the prophet is, plenty of people will be out of church this morning. Did I tell you that? The second thing, I set a point out who will be in church this morning. Did I tell you, Sister Margaret, that lady there, would be in church? I'm putting my Bible.
Sister Margaret from Garrison.
I told you she would be in church. Did I call you? No, I didn't call you. Did I tell you, Brother Clifton and his wife, their family will be here? Did I call you? No, I didn't call you. What I told you again? Spoke of Kumar and Lisa and being in church. While I was touching God with my prayer, God was revealing things to me. So I want to let everybody know, you didn't come here by chance, and you didn't come here just to not receive nothing. But what you come here for, let me tell you something. Whatever you want, God told me. You want a house, you want a land, you want whatever you want. What you have to do, your prayer, your worship must touch God. It must touch God. Morning, Sister Marita. It must touch God, everybody. Whatever you want, it must touch God. Prophetess, what do you think about?
Prophet, when we pray, we have to believe and put we all into we prayers. We can't let distraction come in and distract us from praying with God. But when we pray with God, we have to be locked in with Him and Him
imagine,
only.
When you set up prayer with God, you have to get serious. Put aside your thing. You have to get serious. So you cannot let nothing come there.
So you have to be locked in with Him, because if you are distracted, you will not hear God. God will not hear your prayers. If you're in a classroom in school and you are distracted, you will not learn anything.
Because while the teacher teaching someone doing something madness, will distract you.
And your spirit focus on that.
So your whole focus go on that now, and you forget the whole church. So in your prayer and everything you do, you must not allow anything. Watch me. If you go in and God for something, you have to go in spirit and in truth. Yes, distraction will come. Even sometimes when I'm praying for people out there, I want to ask everybody, when I say I'm praying for people, don't pass a punks man. All right? Because distraction, that will be distraction, people. Because when you really pray, or for instance, you're worshiping, and somebody started worship, somebody raised their hand and hit you in your head. You would turn around and look, and you'll say, oh gosh, this person can shift around a little bit. Well, take up your chair. Why do we have this kind of chairs? When those kind of things happen, move the chair, get rid of the chair. Don't ask somebody to move the chair. You take a picture and put it in the corner and you worship God. And if you find it too small and there's not too much of people come up here, worship God. Amen. But the whole idea is to touch God. Your spirit must be in a place to touch God. If your spirit is not in a place to touch God, forget about all your fancy words and how you look and how you look, and don't care about where your spirit is. Your spirit has to be in a place to touch God. Let me tell you, you want a healing? Your spirit has to be in a place to touch God. Everybody hearing? And that is what we come to church for. When we worship God, we will be able to touch God. Touch. Somebody say hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. What are you experiencing up here this morning, Narissa?
Good morning, everyone. Prophet, you know, while worshiping, you can feel like, you know, it's just a great sense of freedom, a great anointing. And, you know, it feels so good that the inside of it just out, like, you want to just outflow, outburst, everything.
True, true, true. You better believe that. I had to hold Kim Rachel. Kim Rachel is she, but I had to hold him. So I checked him in the back. Because, that, you know, Kim Rachel and she right here. I just use my head alone. I prefer Kim Rachel because I know she can pump herself. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You may have your seats. Everyone, is so good to be in the house of God. God have something so special for you this morning. God have something for you so special. I want to urge everybody, have a good prayer life. Make sure your spirit is in the right place. Make sure you have the right fruit of the spirit, everybody. Amen. If you know your spirit is not tasting good, if you know what is happening in your spirit, it is not God. Could you please take it up on the prayer now? Yeah, if you know what you have in your spirit, it is not God, cry out to God and say, God, take it away from me. Amen. God business, come now. It is serious business. Okay, Brad, I'm going to put you one finger. Come here. She feels good, Brad. She hopes that she can pull me all out. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory. Somebody say glory.
Glory.
I see somebody about me. Say glory. No. And this last says, I'm not going to compromise. Lord, I thank you, Lord, for each and every person this morning. Lord, I thank you, Lord, for all those who know what is right. What is the right thing to do? And they do it. Lord, and those who know what is the right thing to do and does not do it, Lord, I pray, Lord, that you will take a hold of their life, and Lord, you will bring them to that place of obedience. Lord, because we can sing, we can worship, we can praise, we can pray, but Lord, if we are disobedient and doing what is right, Father, everything will be canceled. Lord, it will not make sense. So Lord, this morning, I bless the offering, I bless the tithes. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, amen. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 Hey, God is good. And all the time, He's so good. My God. It's so good. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. Prepare everybody to receive this morning. Amen. If you want to speak, so everybody, spirit, be prepared to receive what God have. God have something for every one of us. Now. Sister Rain, come. Come, sweetheart, come. God have something for every one of us this morning. Amen. Praise the Lord. Are you doing good?
Yeah.
I'm not gonna see that. Good living? Good living? Is he too bad?
No. Not really.
I was gonna say jeans. What? What's he doing?
He's not lying.
What is he doing? What did he say like? Praise the Lord. Right. Real. What do you have to say about the church? What do you have to say about your dreams? What do you have to say?
With dreams, and as far as I see, God is doing something special in each and every one life. I know God is blessing us with whatever our heart desire. And Word in Action Ministry, I just always say Word in Action Ministry is a ministry where songs are birthed and lives are saved. And God is going to take Word in Action Ministry into a new place, into something new. And right now He's just preparing us for that special something.
Because He's preparing all His people for that special place. And to those who are not ready. Because in order to get ready to go in that special place, you have to let go of the old to get into the new. Do not think you can go with your old baggage in that new place. Amen. You won't reach. You won't be accepted in that place.
It's true.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you very much. And something else you wanted to say? Very good. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. God is good. I want to let the church know that we are living in the last days. And in the last days, Satan, he is much alive and he's coming at his God people. He's attacking God people. One of the things he's doing is playing with your mind. When he played with your mind and he captured your mind, then he starts now telling you what to do and you calling, yes, boss. Yes, boss. Anything the devil tell you to do, yes, boss. Let me tell you something. We are the temple of the Holy Spirit. We are the temple of the Holy Spirit. And we are not called to tell God what to do. But God is called to tell us what to do. Now is the time you have to wake up. You are the shake up. You are the shape up. You see, if you don't wake up and shake up and shape up, you wouldn't be able to keep up with the times. It's not a long time enough. It's not a long time enough. The church that we are living last days in, this is the church of Revelation in the Bible. That is where we're living. We're living in the last church that is in the book of Revelation. And in the last book, but the book of Revelation, it said, those who have ears to hear, let them hear. We are not living in a compromising time. If we are about God business, we are about God business. If we are about playing the fool, you are about playing the fool. Amen? We are living in a time that, listen, the serious and the people of God is going to rise up. In these last days, you will see who is for God and who is not for God. Who is for God, they are the ones who will demonstrate that they are for God. The one who speak and say, I'm for God, and no action, waste of time. You don't put no focus on them. But what I'm saying, we are living in a time where prophecy is coming to pass. We are living in a time where prophecy is coming to pass, everybody. We are living in serious time. We are living in a time where you don't play with people's lives. Anybody want to play with people's lives? Boyfriend, girlfriend, this, that, that, that. Go ahead, go ahead. You go ahead. You go ahead. But listen, I am called to ensure that we are much more connected, that we are connected to God. If you come in church and we pray, we just pray with church, but you know, for really and truly, our motive is not really that. Our motive is people. People, let me tell you, take your mind out of people. Do not put your trust in people, put your trust in God. I'm a human being. Do not put your trust in people, but put your trust, I'm a people, but put your trust in God. You always wait for somebody to come and pat you, and this time you need a goal of deliverance now. The person patting you, that person's a bigger devil than you. Amen? Because that person does not want to see you get delivered. That person does not want to see you rise up and go forward. If I'm praying for a person in the office and the next person there with me, and while I'm praying and I'm trying to help this person, see this person get delivered, and I have one next person swell up their mouth like they're sorry, excuse me please, could you go outside so that this person can receive what God really would impart upon their lives? Because you want to see this person change, but you come in around and say, don't worry, girl, I know who prophet is. I know. I'm a good person. Yeah, I'm a good person. I'm working for Satan. You remain right here. Let the devil remain inside you and kill you. Praise the Lord. That is exactly what it means. Hallelujah. Let's turn our pages in your Bible to Luke chapter 8, starting at verse 46. Luke chapter 8, starting at verse 46. Hallelujah. Luke chapter 8, starting at verse 46. Everybody? Luke chapter 8, starting at verse 46. And look how intelligent this scripture is. Look at the amount of wisdom you could get, the amount of food you could get from this scripture this morning, Sunday morning. Let me tell you, this food is better than all your chicken and rice. This food is better than every other food. Except the Mrs. Muhammad food. Praise the Lord. You can't say that to me. If I say this food is better than everybody's food, and she hear me, she can say, oh, prophet, I feel better than my food. Next week Sunday, we'll see nothing for you. Salt. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Way better. Way better. And the word of God said, hallelujah. Verse 46. But Jesus said, someone touched me. Hey. Jesus said, someone touched me. I want to ask a question this morning. When you are to pray and you have to see something happen, something effectively, your prayer must touch Jesus. And when you pray, touch Jesus, whatever you want, he will touch it. He will say, something touched me, someone touched me, someone touched me. He will say, someone touched me. Because you see, your prayer was so compassionate. Your prayer was so real. Your motive was so right. Your tears were so real. Not the crocodile tears in a way, you might be two sides, but you're feeling well, know you're rebellious and you don't want to hear. Not that I'm talking about, you know. I'm talking about that, you know. I am talking about when you pray, Jesus said, someone touch me. Sometimes we ask the question, why God answers some people prayer and he don't answer some people prayer? The reason why? Because your prayer really don't touch him. Your prayer really don't touch him. The Bible says, what God desires is a broken heart and a contrite spirit. When you really come before God, don't come before God and say, Lord, well, you know, you're right, you know, and everybody like to take advantage of me, and everybody like to do me. Shut up! God will answer that prayer. Because God knows about right and wrong. He knows about truth and lie. He knows about all that. He knows about who real and who not real. So if you want God to answer your prayer, listen, your prayer must touch God. You praying and you want God, I'm talking about anything in this world, you want God to do it for you, you feel free to ask him, feel free. You don't need my permission. Ask God for whatever your heart desires. But I want to ask a question. When your prayer touch you, touch Jesus, when your prayer touch him, something else happened to you. You must know your prayer touch him. Because when your prayer touch him, hey, he touch him at the same time. I'll read it. We teach him tonight, this morning, sorry. Hallelujah. We're going to, he said, someone touched me. I know that the power has gone from me. Let me tell you, this is not only about the woman with the issue of blood and no. You see the same touch, the same Jesus. Whatever you want, once you're touching, anything you want, you're going to get it. You see, sometimes people put a focus too much on the woman with the issue of blood. Let me tell you something. In any way you could pray, or you could worship, or you could do something to touch God. God, and as I read, you will see how God, he will recognize it. He said, you know what he said? He said, power! power, Brother Glenn. When you pray and you touch God, power will leave God and it will come to you. When it comes to you, it overpowers all situation. It overpowers what you want. But tell you, you want something? I'm going to pour out this power when he touch you. And the thing you want, it could be the best motor kindly showcase. It could be somebody dying. It could be what? God will overpower what you want. The power will leave him, come to you, and it will take over. You will overpower it. And when you overpower it, when you go to the person, you overpower the person too. So the person have no choice but to bless you. Are you understanding what I'm saying this morning? You understand what I'm saying this morning? Probably you're praying, but your prayer need to be right. You cannot pray for something that is against God's will. You cannot pray for something that is against God's will. Many a time I show I pray for things that is against God's will. Probably I pray for something sure, God won't give me somewhere else, and that is against God's will. Because when God wants to give you what God has for you, you might not know. Probably you prayed for a motor car, but God wants to make you the owner of the company. Huh? God wants to make you the owner of the company. And you prayed for the motor car all the time. And you say, God, I answered the prayer. He wants to answer your prayer. He wants to give you a car. He wants to give you the whole company. Hallelujah! Praise the Lord! Glory! Verse 47 said, then the woman, seeing that she could not go unnoticed, came trembling and fell at his feet in the presence of all the people. She told why she had touched him. This, here is one I've got. Let me read it back. The woman, seeing that she could not go unnoticed, let me tell you something. When God touch you, sometimes you try to hide your testimony, and if God bless you, you try to hide your blessing. Because you feel, if you share your blessing with everybody, the leader of the church or the prophet will come and pull you in a corner. I hear God bless you with real money. You could give us some for the church. You could give us some. Yeah. But that people, that kind of stinking thinking, you know. So they decided to go unnoticed. Let me tell you something. One thing you will never catch me doing, and I always say it, is begging, I beg, never. Because if I beg, I make Jesus a beggar. Test me on anything. Test me on anything. But don't test me that I come and beg you, no. It don't work so. I don't know for other preachers, not for me. Because what I'm saying, that God is a good provider. The woman was blessed. And she realized she could not escape. The word is escape on notice. On notice. If God bless you and you want to bless the ministry, that's between you and God, not between me. Take that out of your head. Amen? Because when you're ready to bless the ministry, you're going, you pray and touch God and say, God, I'm going to do this for you. That's between you and God. And if you want to go and notice, go ahead. Go ahead. Go ahead. No problem. It don't hurt. It don't bite. Everybody. It don't hurt. It don't bite. Let me tell you something. God is more than able. God is more than able to provide for every one of us. God is more than able to provide for His church. God is more than able to provide for anything. Because we serve a big God. Because when you pray and you touch God, something will leave Him. You pray and you touch God. The same way healing come to the woman, money can leave him and come to the church. What do you think about that? What do you think about that? All I think about, I really pray. And he said, Lord, and the right motive, the right thought, Lord, bless me so that I can be a blessing. And you really touch God with your prayer. You sleep tonight and you get up tomorrow. A millionaire. And God just want to see what you would do. Yeah, it's true. Sleep today, get up a millionaire tomorrow. Amen. You woman of little feet. I'm preaching here, you know, prophet is talking about Stephen Ibodike. Hallelujah, Lord bless you, Lord bless you. Hallelujah. Hey, where was I again before I was? We're talking about distraction this morning. Let's see what is happening. You seem to be a preacher and keep the focus, boy. Diatess, you play Job's wife up here, you know. Praise the Lord. Then the woman see that she could not go unnoticed, come with trembling, and fell at his feet in the presence of all the people. She told why she had touched him and how she had been instantly healed. That woman, the word of God said, the woman realized that she could have not gone unnoticed, so she came and she fell down at the feet of Jesus. And she told why she had touched him. She told God, why I had touched you, Lord. You know something I realized with the woman there? She was not an ungrateful woman. She was a very grateful woman. Because I will tell you something. When she came to God, even though she was healed, she was dragging for more than 12 years. She was healed. She went back down on her feet. She went back down on her feet. And she told Jesus why she touched him. You know, it's like not being ungrateful. Jesus did something for her, so she decided to come and tell Jesus, you know, Lord, you know, I didn't ask for permission to come and touch you, Lord, but I was desperate. I was desperate, so Lord, I had to touch you. I had to touch you. Lord, I didn't ask for permission, but I had to touch you. I remember years ago when I was preaching and I get that massive. I didn't ask the preacher to go in the office, you know. Well, he asked me to come and preach. And I went in his office and I see a chaliter bottle, a sweet drink. I just opened it and I'll drink out the whole bottle. I didn't ask for permission because I was desperate. You know, in all the woman desperation, I will tell everybody something. In all the desperation, she did not forget to come back and give God thanks. I want to believe that woman realized after what is the process in touching God. Let me tell you something, Sister Elizabeth. You see how you come and you can't walk too good and then that is the process in touching God. That is the process. I see go to church and this foot, my socks used to be there. At first, I didn't love Jesus. That socks, blood is going to be soaking the socks. And it soaked the shoes and it leaking along. Ask prophetess. And I wanted to be a church. Let the foot deal with itself. Let the foot bleed. You bleed if you want. But you see, I wanted to touch Jesus. And you know, Jesus, see, he saw the desperation that I had. He saw, in spite of your foot bleeding, I reached in church. And I would remain for the whole service. And somebody who care about me would ask me, you sure you can make it for the whole service? I said, the whole service? I don't think any blood in my body got drained out. It gone to my socks, but I'm glad when you really want to touch God, brother, it takes something extra. You don't think you just get up, you put on a jacket, you put on a shirt, you know what I mean, you iron your back. You don't want to take that, you know. There are many people who want to touch God. It will take extra sweat. It will take extra effort. It will say, I don't care if you have inconvenience yourself. A lot of people can't inconvenience themselves. No. They say, yeah, what I have to do, I have to do it first. And after I will see about God. But I want to tell you something. If you have to be one who will already touch God, that is not the procedure. The lady that come from Tobago, Sister Naomi, she gone back to Tobago. The suffering lady. She said she have a business. And she said on Friday, she just go to the hospital. She said she just close her business and go to the hospital. And people is actually, how come she's close it and go to the hospital? She said because she believed that God work come first. And you will find just a few people like that. You won't find much people like that. You will not find much people like that. When you make the extra effort to reach God, God will reach you. You see, no wonder why people, when they get sick and they're dying in a bed and they're crying and they reach to the last, then God has come and picked them up. I don't understand why. Because you see, while they're more healthy and thing, they pray really, don't touch God. But when they reach the last stage, let me tell you, the real tears, they say, oh God, now I go there. Oh God, now. Lord, if you come now, all over. And that last cry out, God come and touch you. All the crying before, they find nothing happening. People, God is a loving God. And God wants to touch everybody's heart. Let me tell you something, when God touches you inside, it's never the same again, you know. You think that woman released your blood, she just gets your healing, and she comes and she confesses to God, to Jesus that, you know, why I touch you really, and after that, she won't be going living her worldly life, carnival, she won't be going and jumping up in her band. You think so? Huh? No, I don't believe that. I don't believe that. And that's why, you know something, I always confess, people who go through a real problem, and they come to God, probably you come to this church and God touch you. And just look out for those to be the faithful one. Those to be the faithful, the grateful, thankful to say, Lord, if you didn't come and touch me at that time, I would not be alive. Lord, I'm alive today and I can put my fist up on your face. I just look out to see day. Look out to see them. I, Sister Rena, I look up at Sister Rena, where she was. I remember now that in my heart operation, me and Brian, I couldn't hold Rena. Yeah? Rena would be pelting, cough, kid. Brian, if you see Brian. Brian had a hold she. Long, long way now. And then up to today, Rena would have full respect for me. And if I say, Rena, if I ask you anything, yes. Because Rena knew that when she needed a touch, God touched you. And Rena, God touched you. That gratefulness mustn't be for a month or 2 months or 3 months. Why, yeah, let me tell you, God touched me 10 years ago in a special way. And let me tell you something, long as I live, I'll be grateful to God. Long as I live, I'll be grateful to God. Way down the road, don't you want to be ungrateful? You're not real people. You're not real people. And nothing, let me tell you, nothing in this world, nothing in this world could come and cause me to be sidetracked from God. Nothing. Nothing, 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 nothing. When God touch you, people, when God touch you, and you see that depend a lot on your focus. If you come to church and your focus is on something else and people and people and people, let me tell you, you're on the wrong track. You want people to touch you. That's what you're looking for. And if people don't touch you, you're disappointed. So that is to show you your motive and your intention, everything was wrong and evil. God touch you. Let me tell you something. When God touch you, you will never be the same again. Not everybody in a church go to church that God already touched them. No. Sometimes God wants to touch them and then push away back God. God wants to touch them, they push away back God. God wants to touch them, he wants to deliver them, they push away back God. They push away back God. God wants to bring something to them, they push away back God. Because you know why? They like the old life. All the old nastiness that we continue to operate in, they love that. All them old kind of thing, gossip and hey, this and that. You trying to help people, but there will be people right in the church coming and saying, no, the prophet trying to kill you. You see, he's trying to offend you, he's trying to harass you, he's trying to make you shame. Hey. the people is God fearing people, they should fear God. Because by doing that, God could strike you down. God could strike you down. Because of you yourself, you are the same thing. So you will support. You will support wickedness. You will support that. People, I always say, God called me. God called me to help people. God called me to see people rise up. And let me tell you something, the truth, what is offended? The truth. Point out something, point out the truth, and you will see people. And by the way, when people offend, they need a deliverance. They have a big devil inside of them. Amen? They need deliverance. So, the woman said, some, because, you know why I say that? Let me tell you why. Because when you become a Christian, you're supposed to be dead to self. When you see self start a voice and voice and voice, you're much alive in the flesh. You do fleshly. You do fleshly. People. God is raising up a spiritual army. I was hearing on the television last night and they was commenting on ISIS. And one girl come, prophetess was watching the television as well. And the girl said, killing out all of them would make sense. Just go and killing all of them, it would make sense. Get to the root of it, get to the root of it. So I was watching and I was thinking, I wonder if she really knows where's the root. What is the root of it? Let me tell you, the answer to the root of it is in the Bible. The root of all evil is Satan. The root of it is to make sure the spirit being transformed and they be born again so they live a new life. That's the root of it. That's the root of it. Because you cannot continue living a whole life. You cannot continue worshiping what you're doing. I want to change. Become just like any Christian in this church. You cannot continue your wickedness. You cannot continue your gossiping. You cannot continue. You just see, I need the church. You always, yeah, that one right, that one wrong, that one right. Let me tell you, God could take them CIDs, right? So, you like that. You're the overlooker. You know everything. So, you cannot continue like that and yet won't change. The Bible said, let every man be a liar. Every man be a liar and let God be truth. Let God be truth. Let everyone be a liar and let God be truth. And this morning I asked the question, I wonder how truthful we are to God. How truthful. And I wonder your way of life. You know, Jesus said, it's not my way, but it's his way. Your way of life. I wonder how right you could really be. Because if you are so right, then nothing wrong will be happening. You don't take two right to make a wrong, and I don't take two wrong to make a right. So if I am so right, I believe everything right is supposed to be happening. So, what I'm saying this morning, God wants to touch everyone. Where your weakness is, if your weakness is confusion, you want to touch it. If your weakness is nobody can trust you, he want to touch you. He want to touch you. He want to touch you. He want to touch everyone. He want to touch you. Let me tell you, many of us, we go through all kind of pain, we go through all kind of problem, we go through all kind of family problem, we go through, neighbor problem, all kind of problem we go through now. But if we just only allow, we don't go through church problem again, you don't have no church problem again. Because my prayer didn't touch God. Amen? Once my prayer touch God, God knows to touch them. Amen? God knows to touch them. God is a good God! God is a powerful God! God is an awesome God! You know why me and you is alive today? It's because God touched me, you know. Everybody. If God had never touched you, I remember a girl called, she got the church here, and people just make me laugh. She told me, I want to come to church, but the passage you're doing here is $56 from the Martin. So I said, that ain't plenty, that ain't even plenty. She said, well, do you check it? To come and to go back is $36. I said, that's not plenty. She said, how you mean prophet, that's not plenty? I said, for God, that's not plenty. You will compare God with $36. Judas sell Jesus for 36 pieces of silver. So that is not plenty. So I tell her, she said, well, I said, well, even so dear to come to church here, well, find a church anywhere in Diego Martin, right here where you live in. Make sure you find a Holy Ghost filled church. And you can go home and make sure, check home, make sure that the church really, the Spirit of God is in the church, the man of God is connected with God. Make sure, now check out your thing. You know what she told me, tell me? She told me, tell me, so prophet, you want to run me now? I said, Lord, how will you please people? She said, prophet, you want to push me away from the church now? I said, 1 minute, you're telling me $56 is too much. No, I'm telling you, I'm giving you an advice. Find a church somewhere close to where you live in, where you won't have to spend penny passage. She said, I want a church with substance. So I said, well, what? But I know what she's trying to say now. She want to come to a church where it has virtue, where the anointing is flowing, where the Spirit of God is flowing. She said, I want a church with substance. I said, well, go and check for substance. Go walk with a glass and make sure you get substance. She said, you make a mockery out of me, no. I said, but I'm telling you, even down here, go far. Go right where you're living down there. She said, I'm trying to run you from the church. What do you really think about that? Are you going to really please people? But again, what do you think about that? What? What do you don't want to say? What I should have tell you, man, $36 too much. So I said, find a church next to where you live in, where you might pay $3 or $5 and they reach a church and they go back home. Where is it?
You had to come here.
I know she had to come here. Did the guy know that? But she had to make the extra stretch. She had to do some more praying. She had to pray and she had to tell God, give she some more money. She need more passage. Yeah. But I was trying to make it easier for her and tell her. Even though I know what I was doing. Because I know when God really assigned somebody to go somewhere, that's where you have to go. So, everybody, those are so many things I was facing up with. when you call me, don't call me to make my life harder. No. If you call me, and you call me, you want help, I'm going to help you. But don't call me to make my life harder. No. But it's so much, and this, I will go all that easy, I'm better for you. That's right. She said, you tried to run me. Hey! Praise the Lord! God is good. Everybody, say Jesus! 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 Hallelujah! Praise the Lord! Thank you, Jesus. Then he said to her, daughter, your faith has healed you. Go in peace. Have you sold anything then? No. Then he said, daughter, your faith has made you whole. Go in peace. Your faith has made you all go in peace. I want to believe that if the woman did not have faith, her prayer would not even touch God. You see, when you're really praying for something, the devil is bringing all kind of distraction to you. All kind of distraction to you. Because he want to distract you from what you really want. But because the woman had a focus and she decided that I will not stop until Jesus heal me. You might want a healing for somebody. You might want something. A distraction will come. Sometimes the very people that you think will be there supporting you in order to go towards that. Let me tell you, distraction will come, it will come. And listen, if you and you alone have to go, keep your focus at home. Because this is not about man, but it is about God. Don't let nothing distract you in this life. Nothing distract you. When you have to go out for something, I want to say something. I know God do something so big for me last weekend. Hey. Something so great. I've been praying and asking and crying out to God. And I said, Lord, I know you will do it, you know. I know you will do it. And God just do it for me. When God did that for me, you know what? It gave me more courage. More courage to do one work. And I would live longer again to do God's work. God did something so great. And I want to say to the church this morning that I show in your mind, you prepare your mind, and you want God to do something for you. And on your way, distraction come, the devil jump. Probably the devil jump on yourself, he jump on somebody close to you, and he just distract you. He is tracking. And you lose your focus. You see, when you lose your focus, I want to tell you, you lose your blessing. When you lose the road that you was going down for your blessing, when you lose track of that word, because in the end of that road, there lies your blessing. You allow the devil to come and make you feel sorry for you. Everybody only want to do me this, and everybody want to do me. Oh God, shut up your mouth. There is a real devil, and there is a real God. People, this is how they for Jup Jup Christian, you know. Jup Jup is a wooden plate. With apple and cake and grapes and pudding for Christmas for people to eat. You that chum chum Christian? Sophie, Sophie! What? laughing. Tell Mary's. I'm feeling bad, but go. Take the next road, and you will get your blessing. You jump, yeah. It hurt. The bad jump, you man. The small jump. Is that the kind that's melting your mouth? Was it more melt? So Mohammed make a dance, Monday go on. But the only one that she after that. I think Stephen came out. I'm faint from she wasted the boat. And whole week she'll get therapy. I said, nah, that woman's strong boy. I think that's the boat. Yeah, Brother John put the hand in the waist and he watched the roof. You ever see Brother John shut up? He didn't know what to do again. What did you see Mr. Norman kick out his slippers and then? She on fire? And there she. Oh! Hallelujah! When you're in Christ, you're a new creation! Everybody, let me tell you something. In this last days, you're a softy Christian. Survive in the wilderness. You can't survive in the church if you put it in as a prayer. Hallelujah! God is good! Somebody say hallelujah! 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 Hey, people, the woman said, Jesus said, somebody touched me and power left me, you know. So I can imagine the power of God when it come down in this church. It's the same power the woman touched Jesus and it come down and it touched him. But the purpose the power came down for was to heal the woman. But that same power could come down to do anything. When you go to church, I believe whatever you do must touch Jesus. So that is why you give it your all. You surrender your all. You praise with your all. You make an extra stretch with your all. Don't just go to church. I was telling Kim Ranjan, I think Brother Matt knows. I said, no human being could separate me from God. No human being. The only time a human being could separate you from God is if your whole focus on a human being. Never. Because if you stop me from talking to my God, I could talk to him in my house. If you're sick, come on. No human being. Well, I'm going to church, you know, and because of that one, and because of this one. No, you was going to church for the wrong reason. Because you think if you close your eye and you look up to Jesus, somebody will come, open your eye and tell you, don't look. And then you will come and then there will some human being stop you from your relationship with God. You could have been preaching here and I could have been anywhere I'm sharing. but you could stop my relationship from God. I remember I was going to church and New Testament Church of God, Montrose, and another girl was a nurse. She was sitting next to me. She was my good friend. The prophetess was there, and while service was going on, after she held my hand, and she held my hand and she said, "What is that?" And I think anointing came, like electricity. And she said, "What is that?" I said, "Nothing." Because while I was on the pews, my spirit was touching God. I was touching God. I do not have to be up here in order to touch God. I do not. I can be anywhere in the church and I can touch God. So we're trying to say, only the people up here can touch God. So people down there can't touch God. You see, we have to educate the church. You have to really give your heart, your soul, your mind, your spirit in order to touch God. If you want, let me tell you something. Every time God shake up and wake up something in you, you're supposed to recognize it. And you're supposed to recognize that it's not of God. And if you try to pat it down on the person back, you try to push it down and say, no, he's a good person. I try to push down that devil inside of them. Let me tell you, you will have that person suffering as long as they live. Because God stopped the water so that you can bring out the old, and you are trying to push it on back with your deceiving words. And later down the road, you know what you will be saying? Let me tell you what you will be saying. If I take the opportunity that I get to be delivered today, I would have been a better person. But because I had supporters who worked for the devil, supporting me in my wickedness, I am who I am. I was telling the prophet, is anybody close to me? I would like to see them really be delivered. But if you're close to me, you better get close to God too. The my thing is God. My focus is God. So if you're close to me, you better get close to God. Because you cannot say, you're close to me, and you want to be far away from God. Yes, I know God will stop things in your life. There's a time God will stop things in everybody's life. And when he stood up, he'll bring it out. So people, this morning in church, I want to let everybody know that God is serious about his people. And if you know your desire and your focus in the wrong place, you see, if you start coming to church and you start coming to praise God, and all of a sudden you're going in man and woman and boy and girl, let me tell you, you'll lose your road. That is why he like how you is. That is why you can't see betterment coming in your life. You can't see improvement in your spiritual journey with God. There's a scripture Paul said, I was running a good race, but who cut in on me? Let me tell you something, you could be running a good race. I know devil has come from outside the church, you know. Some religious, some kind of spiritual religious, you wouldn't believe it. They would rise up from right in the church and mislead you and take you in the wrong road. And when you go down the wrong road, and you go back to them and say, you know what's going good, and you advise me this, and you tell me this, you know what you would say? But you didn't do it the way I tell you. I told you what to do it, so you want to do it the wrong way. So in other words, they're trying to say, take out yourself completely. They try to take out themselves from misleading you when they were supposed to lead you. Because I'm sure I'm the leader of Wooden Action Ministry. And I'm sure there are many in the congregation. Probably just want to lead people. They just want to lead people. But when you really lead people, just tell yourself, I am leading you. So if anything happened to you, you be responsible for that, not me. Don't put me in that. Don't put me in that. If the person shall run into trouble, come back to you. Come back to you. Come back to you. Come back to you. There are many, many. Let me tell you something. Satan is working with a strategy. He's working with deception. Can you always say, right in this church, if people mislead people and that person run into trouble, I'm going to ask them who really advised them. And I'm going to take the phone and call that person and I will say, come, I want to see you. When they come, I say, go pray for that person now. That's your work. That's what you do. Your mouth put you in trouble. Your advice, when you think you know, you didn't know anything, you run that person into problem. No, take them out of it. And what I'm talking about over 10 years ministry and experience in being in ministry over 10 years. This is what I'm talking about. Some of them might even think they know more than me. I'm telling God if they know. I'm telling you. And they will say, don't worry, prophet. You don't worry, prophet. Come, listen to what I have to say. But I pray to God, when you run into people into trouble, I pray to God that you can take them out back. You can bring them out back. And no grandma crying, no pity, sorry, and say, well, you know, I only tell she this and I only tell she that, and that's what happened. No. It ain't no time for no sorry day. People, we are in the last days. And I'm saying that we need to touch God. Everybody, we need to touch God. Take your spiritual life very serious. Very serious. Watch out for these con artists. Watch out for these jup-jup preachers. Watch out for this jup-jup Christian. Watch out. You need to watch out. Watch out for them. Watch out for them. Because their words don't line up with their action. Amen? Their words do not line up with their action. Can I call you to the front, please? Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah! God is good. God is so good. You need to watch out. You need to watch out. The Bible says, watch and pray. Watch and pray. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Just you practice and dance yesterday. What's the name of it? Amen.
Keep me in the valley.
Jesus a big clap. Thank you, Yus. Thank you very much. Up. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Well, this morning, everybody, Steve became a big man yesterday. For those who don't know, yesterday Steve was 21 years. 21 years. Yesterday was 21 years. So, today we're going to celebrate his birthday. Celebrate his birthday today, everybody. One birthday we have today. How much birthday we have? Get much. Steve is 21 years yesterday. So, if you want to celebrate your birthday, you know, birthdays is very good things. Up there, right? Gabby, the helper up there. hospitality. Kabizi Hospital. Right. So everybody, I want a church beat. I want a tuba beat. Happy birthday to you. Come on. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you, Joshua. We come to us. We love you very much. We love you, Sammy. You dance, 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 buddy. Just dance, dance. We love you very much. Dance. We love you. We love you. We love you very much. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to Lisa. Happy birthday to Jason. Happy Steve. Happy birthday to Steve. We love you very much, much, much. We love you very much, much, much. Love you. We love you. We love you very much. Lisa, you don't walk with the fire brigade. Right? You got all fire. She, one blow, she nearly blew off all Steve Candle from he gave and all of that. I don't really have some mountain. Oh, Lord. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Take up the volume, man. Take up the volume, man. You have to be very romantic, man. Have I seen the most romantic set of people up here? How you're putting cake, how you're looking them in the eyes, how you're getting here and going to dance.
Can't wait to be alive.
Thank you so much. I see Lolita started crying. She remember when she was young. Yeah. What you see? Jesus. All of us are gonna sit here and squeeze up. So I feel cool one time. Praise the Lord. Thank you very much, everybody. God is good. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Steve, Giselle, I want to say, prophetess, come say something in behalf of Stephen. I want to say something in behalf of Lisa. Come fast. I want to say something in behalf of Lisa. Because I think I know Lisa a long time. See, what did you say about Steve?
Prophet, I just want to say happy birthday again. Don't mind a forgetty birthday yesterday. We just want to say we're sorry. I remember it Wednesday, he said. But
so what do you know about Steve because on his birthday?
Prophet, he's a good boy, very respectable. Yeah, he's like a son to me, if the church don't know him. We consider him like we one of our own. And we just want to say we love you very much. And we pray that God will, we know God will bless you with long life, prosperity, and you have a good future ahead of you. And we thank God for you.
Well,
knowing you.
I want to say about Lisa. I know she got this, she's sitting there. She's a very nice girl. She's like a tante to me. It's so long. She's like a little more than so, I've known Lisa for, how much years now, Lisa? Marissa, you tell she now, you know. Huh?
Seven.
How much?
Seven.
How much?
Seven.
7 years. Right. I know she for 7 years and I'm still alive. 7 years I know she. Alright? And Lisa is a very funny girl. She's very funny. Amen. And sometimes she could be very serious. But I pray right now she's very serious when she got it. I see she and Kumari have been coming out every Sunday, and I want to thank God for she. Amen. Kumari picture. Kumari, before they married, Kumari went for a video. She was working in a video shop. Let me tell you the story. He went for film. While he watching the film, he looking at the film, sir. So, he went and he take the film. And next time he wanna flip, but he go into the video camera to study. He wanna flip, he wanna be gathered. But this time the only flip he wanna see is that girl. The one who sell the flip. Yeah, huh? Yeah, you understand that he wanna make one. Alright, how Giselle get to know Stephen. Kim Ranch was the look at in this area. Kim Ranch was the look at Kim Ranch was the contact. And while that was going on, I didn't even know. But they come to know each other. Everybody, they come to know each other. Everybody come to know each other in some mysterious way. They don't ask me why I come to know Prophet. Because she come to know me. Amen? She come to know me. And when she come to know me, well, I had to come back to know she. And I thought he really take over. So, we have known Steve. Steve, how long we know you now? 4 years. Sister Lolita started coming to church first. And then she started bringing she son. And when he come, he said, sit on the quiet. Steve is sit on the quiet. And when he come in for Steve with the little, he said, come and tie anything?
Yeah.
He said, come and tie any shit on the. And he said, a quiet little boy sit on right there. You would never believe that he go like yell on thing, eh? The boy looks so innocent. I guess I'm right there, but after when I come to know her, I come to know Steve. She said, Lolita, she started telling me, Steve? And when I was in the world and Steve started to dance, ask him. Yeah. But I said, my mood will fall far from me, true. So, we know Steve for a moment, she has now. How much years yet?
17.
17, huh?
4 years.
And I'm going to check on all the shows. What am I checking for myself? 1, 17, 18, all the check on my 19, 20, 21. Is it like a check for myself? So we have known Steve for 4 years, and Steve has been, you know, not perfect. He has his ups and his downs, but you know something? He remains standing. Everybody get up. But some fall and they can't get up. But Steve remains standing. It's not about you falling and you're getting up and you're falling. It's about you getting up. When you get up and you stand up, once you remain standing, you're good to go. Amen. So Steve, I want to say on behalf of you, on behalf of your mother, and your father went to be with the Lord, I won't be able to be in the party because I think the goat had been done by. I think there's only me and Raja going up there. But praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Happy birthday, Steve. Love you. God bless. Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you. Right. Everybody, we got a lot. Sad to dismiss. Anything else? That's it. Okay. That's it. Actually, anything else? That's it. That is a shame. We're not perfect. The key is a shame to talk to. What is it? So, good afternoon, Derry.
Good afternoon.
How are you?
Great.
You have to say fine.
Fine.
I can see that.
Oh, Lord.
Yeah. And then I ask you, how are you? Say fine.
Fine. All right.
I can see that, Miss Fine.
Fine.
Right, Miss Fine. Today is what day? Today is Sunday. Today's Sunday. Tonight we have a prophetic service. Amen. We have a prophetic service tonight. It'll be very, very wonderful, very, very nice. As we always say that, when you get up and you come out of your own free will, without somebody in a bed, you come now. You ain't ready for God yet. Amen? So if you choose to lie down and you're watching TV, you're watching fowl, walking around the yard, you're watching in the family peachtree, that's your choice. But we have the prophetic service tonight, right? And tomorrow, Monday is where we have intercession. We intercede for the whole church. Amen? The prophetess and all those who normally be here, we intercede for the whole church. So, the church is under prayer 24/7. Right, what we have on?
Tuesday morning,
let me talk about Tuesday morning. Alright, Tuesday morning, everybody. We have a great prayer meeting here. Mistress Marmette and all the rest, they can be a witness to that. We have a beautiful time. Sister Angela, all of them. We have a beautiful time here Tuesday morning in the presence of God. We start at 10. Sister Margaret in the back there as well. I might forget name or not. I don't like to call name, but if I forget one person's name. So we start at 10, Brother Marcos. And we finish at 12. We just look forward for that Tuesday morning. We ain't looking backward for Tuesday morning. Backward will be Monday morning. You look forward for Tuesday morning. From Monday, you have to look forward for Tuesday morning. If you go backward, you go back to Sunday and Saturday. Right. So we look forward for Tuesday morning. You can tell me what Tuesday night.
So Tuesday night at 7 p.m. we have prayer meeting. For those who don't know, we sit around in a circle, the chairs, prophets and prophetesses to the front. We come, we share dreams, you know, anything, any experiences you had during the week, you want explanation, you know, things that you have in your heart that you want to speak out. You know, there's a lot of teaching on that days as well. Feel free to come on a Tuesday and on a Wednesday evening as well, 7 p.m.
Praise the Lord. And very soon, prophetess will have to be teaching on a Tuesday night, not for long. Alright? Till I'm back. Amen? So, prophetess will be teaching on a Tuesday night. Everybody? It won't be for long. Once service, two service on a Tuesday night. prayer meeting. All right? Wednesday. Wednesday night. What we have Wednesday night?
Prayer meeting. And it's very fun.
Prayer meeting, meaning prayer to the touch God.
Exactly. And it's very effective, people. When you come out, there's a lot of learning, you know. It's like a lot of praying as well, and you get like one-on-one prayer with the prophet too. So it's good to come out on a Wednesday and a Tuesday, especially for the youths.
Very true. Because, you know, for the youths, my thing, Friday is more excited and that music and hand dance. Let me tell you something. Prayer meeting is more better. It's structure your spirit, it's structure your life. You know, Friday, yes, we have church and thing, but don't look for glamour and glitter now. Look to see your life straighten up now. Amen? Look to see your life. And as I always say, sometimes one youth is discouraging next, and the next is discouraging next. And when you do see the whole batch of youths, while they were supposed to be in prayer meeting, one influence the next, and the next, and the next. And I don't know, probably all they open their phone like that. What are they going to do? Texting, doing something? I don't know. So, people, be a God worker, don't be a devil worker, right? Encourage, if you love somebody, encourage them to be doing the right thing and not the wrong thing. Because anybody encourage you to do the wrong thing, it's not your friend and it's not of God. Alright? Right. That is
Wednesday night.
So, Thursday night.
Thursday night we have preaching class starting at 7 p.m. Also this Thursday, the last Thursday of the month, will be radio station on W107.1 at 9:30. Please tune in your radios.
Choose to listen.
Okay. Right, so on Thursday at 9:30, W107.1. And for those who want to contribute, there's a board to the back. Feel free for the radio ministry. Amen.
Now, that is for the radio ministry. If you want to contribute, I must let the church know that when we went in into this new station, everything doubled, the money doubled up. The price we used to pay, 98, we doubled, it's doubled. All right? We used to pay like 970 something dollars. That's why it was in 98.1 FM. So now it doubled up. So we have a board there. If you contribute, that's up to you. We'll see your name up. So when you want to see all those that contribute, after church, you must watch up on the board and you will see the contributors. The names that you do not see, those are the ones that do not contribute towards the radio station. All right? Let me tell you, the main focus why you contribute is that somebody might hear the word of God out there and